Hey, I'm Jeff Price, CEO and founder of Audium, and before that, founder and former CEO of TuneCore. And I've invited you to ask me music business and copyright questions, and I'll answer them. So another one just came in. This is a good question. It's from Adele. Not that Adele. Adele McAleer. And she asks, do non-US artists need to register with the US Copyright Office? Will registration in home country suffice? Presuming that plays come from USA, services are based in USA, licensing can be in USA, is there a vulnerability for not taking that step? So the answer to your question is we have something called the Berne, that's B as in boy, E-R-N-E, the Berne Convention. And the Berne Convention says that all the countries in the world that are part of this agree that the laws of the country where the music was sold or streamed will apply. So no matter where you live in the world, be it Zimbabwe, South Africa, Egypt, Greece, Israel, England, Ireland, and so forth, if your music streams in the United States, even if you live in these other countries, the rules and laws of the United States will apply, right? So then the question becomes, what are those rules and laws? Well, the first thing you should be aware of, and this gets a little complicated, is prior to the passage of the Music Modernization Act, which is a new law which was passed in October of last year, in order for anyone, be it a US citizen or somewhere else in the world, to be eligible to get paid their songwriter royalties, and these are called mechanical royalties, they had to actually register their copyright at their own expense and their own time at the US Copyright Office and get something called a PA number, a registration number. Without that registration number, and without doing that, technically, legally, you were not eligible to be paid your mechanical royalties. Actually, you didn't really earn them. In addition, although you had a copyright, the way the law in the United States worked is if you didn't register that copyright with the US Copyright Office, you would not be eligible to pursue what's called statutory damages for the infringement of your copyright. So what that means is if I'm a music service or somebody else, and I stole your copyright, used your music, either your lyric and your melody, or the recording of your lyric and melody, and I did that without a license from you, I've infringed on your copyright, and then I could be sued for copyright infringement. But if you didn't register with the US Copyright Office, then you could not pursue something called statutory damages, which are monetary damages that can be awarded by a court or a jury to you up to $150,000 for each willful infringement, if indeed the infringement was willful. So statutory damages allows a judge or a jury to arbitrarily decide how much money you're going to be paid for the infringement of your copyright, because it's very hard to quantify or qualify what the damage might actually be. So unless you register with the US Copyright Office, you are not eligible to pursue those damages, even if you live in another country, because it's happening in the United States of America. Now, with the passage of the Music Modernization Act and the launching of something called the Mechanical Licensing Collective in the first quarter, like January, February, March of 2021, you no longer will need to register your copyright with the US Copyright Office to be eligible to get paid and earn mechanical royalties. Instead, you will now need to proactively go to the Mechanical Licensing Collective organization, some website that is yet to exist, and register with that. And if you register with that, it makes you eligible to get paid. Of course, this means you need to know about it, and we hope that they communicate this with you. So that is a very long-winded explanation, but registration with the US Copyright Office now is not required with the passage of the Music Modernization Act and the launch in January of 2021 of the Mechanical Licensing Collective to be eligible to get paid your mechanical royalties. That said, it appears no one kept track of this anyway with the streaming services like Spotify and Apple Music and so forth. So even if you did not register with the US Copyright Office, you still would get paid your mechanical royalties. But the benefit now of registering with the US Copyright Office is the ability to pursue statutory damages in the event of infringement. Let's see what else was in there. Presuming the plays come from USA, blah, 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 is there a vulnerability for not taking that step? So that would be your vulnerability. Your vulnerability would be you couldn't pursue statutory damages, and prior to the passage of the MMA, technically, legally, you actually weren't eligible to be paid your mechanical royalties. All that said, the reality is if you write a song and then that song gets recorded, right? You write it, that's one copyright. You record it, that's the second copyright. Whether you record it or not doesn't matter. That recording goes live in the United States and it streams here on Spotify or Apple Music or Google Play or Amazon Prime or Amazon Music Unlimited or Pandora Interactive. The rules of the US will apply, and that recording of your song will generate those songwriter royalties called mechanical royalties. And then the next question becomes, how does that money make it to you? Starting in January of 2021, you will need to register with the Mechanical Licensing Collective to get that money. Prior to 2021, they're supposed to be paying you directly, no matter where you are in the world, and get the license from you directly. And that's a service that Audium provides, because typically this doesn't happen, but we can help out with that if you like. So I hope that answers your question, and thanks for asking.